A Minneapolis woman recently celebrated her 100th birthday with cards coming in from all across the country. Well-wishers reaching out after her story of a unique friendship forged over a backyard fence traveled far and wide. Tonight, Boyd Hupert catches up with fence friends, now turned birthday buddies.
The adjoining backyards are empty.
Good morning.
The usual occupants.
We're going to go to a party.
Have plans.
I think somebody's having a birthday.
Plans. In the church basement.
Yay!
Thank you.
Where Mary O'Neill is marking 100 years. Plans she wouldn't think of making. Without her best bud. Benjamin Olson.
Hi.
Mary, rocketing into her second century.
Benjamin.
And Benjamin.
High five.
Barely started.
High five.
His second year.
Give it a kick. Here comes the rainbow. We call it cane ball.
The friends found each other over their backyard fence.
Wow, two balls.
While they found themselves stuck at home during COVID.
His first best friend.
Go!
Then, after being featured on Carol Levin, the world.
Tonight, a story for the ages.
Found them.
The Daily News in the UK picked it up.
USA Today, The Washington Post.
This one's in Vietnamese. This one's in Icelandic.
300 birthday cards mailed from 21 states.
We would go to the post office, and he would just love to open it up and see all the cards that we got.
She just keeps touching everybody.
Mary's daughter, Sue, believes.
Oh boy, I'm gonna get some dirt.
None of this happened by accident.
Thank you. Oh, that's nice dirt.
Benjamin was sent to her to make her move and make her go.
In addition to Mama and Dada, Benjamin recently started saying,
there's Mimi.
The same Mimi gracing the church basement walls through the years. Graduate, wife and mom, grandmother and great-grandmother. And even as she celebrates a century.
Good song.
Still room for Mary's latest role as Benjamin's best friend.
Everyone loves a good story, and this certainly is one.
Boyd Hupert, Carol Levin News.
Hi, Benjamin.
Robbinsdale.
Mary and Benjamin's story first came to us as a viewer tip. If you have a story you'd like to share with Boyd, you'll find a place to leave your suggestions on his Land of 10,000 Stories page at carolevin.com.